G'day. This video is to demonstrate making your first color-coded working diagram, part 3. Moving on now to the trail. First thing we're going to do is remove these markers that we'd left from the last video. Zoom in. And notice that this one here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from the point. And this one here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this point here of this trail, which is the turning point, is also going to be this point here. So in theory, we've also got another piece that's running from here to there. What this means to you and I is we are going to start here when we work our weaving pair. Now I said earlier, this is going to be in cloth stitch, so our smooth curve needs to be purple. Make sure it's 2 and make sure that the snap to grid is turned off. Putting in the weaver, we start from the center, as I was saying, out and around, around this one, which is actually the pivot pin. And then out around here. Now this next little bit I'm going to do over the next 2 pins is going to be my repeat, so let's get this right. And around, trying to stop it at level with the other one where it started. There. Let's see if that worked. Selected, snap to grid, copy, and paste. No, it isn't quite perfect. That bottom one there needs to come up just still on snap to grid. That one there needs to come up and join there. Remove this one because that's a copy of the previous one that was wrong. Highlight it, copy, snap to grid, and paste. Continue on this way. That gives us our repeat. Now let's just take that top ones from here to here. Drop them down one row. Yes, they do match up. Beautiful. Scroll out a little bit. And now we're looking at putting in our passives. Again, I'm starting from the corner, so I'm starting from this corner and working my way that way. And then I'm starting from this corner and working up that way. Change to smooth curve. Make sure snap to grid is turned off. And let's start putting in our passives for our trail. Now this one here, you'll notice it goes around the corner and then out until we get here. I'm finding it too difficult to separate my passives from my weavers, so I'm going to select my passives and put them on a layer of their own, holding down the control key and using the item select. I'm going to select my passives. Go to home, change the layer to layer 9. It's asking me, do I want to put these onto layer 9? I'm going to say yes. Deselect. Now I'm just going to lock that for the moment. I'm going to go one further. I'm going to make invisible those ones and finish the weaving part of the trail. Let's see, from here. So there should do it. Copy, snap to grid. Put that in. And drop the next one in. I can come back and delete the bits I don't need down the bottom. And delete those out. Now I can change my layer, lock that layer, and go back to layer 9, which has got my trails on it, unlock them and unhide them. Let's copy those ones, go to Drawing Tools, Group Select, copy, snap to grid. Come down and go paste, and paste again. Now I'm going to bring these out to the side here. Select them, and then I'm going to use the right mouse click, transform, flip, horizontal, which has given me my other direction. Copy them, just see if they'll fit in without a problem. Perfect. We can come back and cut these out if we don't need them. Scroll up, here's one more lot up here. Now it's a case of just neatening things up. Select these ones and delete them. Go to the bottom and delete these ones here. Select delete on the keyboard, select delete on the keyboard, and then just quickly write them straight in using a turning off snap to grid. And after I finish this, I'll go back up to the top and do the top. And as you notice this, it also is very obvious that you needed 1, 2, 3 pairs of passives in here and one that comes down. So doing the working diagram is another way of checking your work. I've got 3 here, so let's see. I've got 1, 2. Obviously, I should have another passive running through here. I can either input an extra passive, or I can remove that 3 and make it 2. Zoom out. Look at my work. If I'm happy with it how it is, I'm just going to change that 3 to 2. So let's go down to Numbers. Unlock that. Go Item Select. Select it. Right mouse click. Edit text. And change that from 3 to 2. Save the file. Now, if you're going to import it into a InDesign, you'll want to go File, Save As, an encapsulated postscript. If, however, you just want to save it so you can email it to a friend, then Portable Document Format, or PDF, would be the best bet. Or if you want to import it into a Word document, JPEG format would work better for that. And the internet, of course, is a PNG format. So in this case, I'm going to do encapsulated postscript, choose by grid, and I make all my working diagrams at 5 millimeters diagonal, because I want them to be nice and big. Yes, save. And that's exported.